Hi, and welcome to part 4 of our 3D Vista e-learning tutorials. As you may know, in the past couple of years, VT Pro has evolved to become one of the most famous tools to create immersive and interactive e-learning experiences from beginning to end. The possibility to combine any of the already known functions within standard virtual tour creation with e-learning aspects such as scoring, quiz cards, or treasure and hazard hunts make it the most versatile tool for immersive teaching and testing in digital twin environments. Up to now, however, you had very limited options to adapt the style and layout of the e-learning elements. This has since changed, and we would like to show you in this tutorial how you can customize your quiz cards and score windows, how you can optimize content management, and how to use another new e-learning function which pauses the time while a visitor watches a video or replies to a quiz card. We redesigned the entire e-learning subtab to incorporate some new functions and, most importantly, to allow you to customize the e-learning window designs from quiz cards to score and timeout windows. So you're no longer tied to the standard layout and visuals of these windows, but can instead completely customize the whole experience to your or your client's corporate identity or make it fit to the content colors of the rest of your tour. Let's have a detailed look. Right, so the first thing we see here is the incorporation of this new panel here. This is basically a list or a summary of all the quiz cards we have added throughout the tour, where we can see all of our quiz cards at once, and we can even go in and edit them directly from here. So this is a great new addition in terms of centralized content management. So we have the name or the wording of the question, and very useful indeed, the media in which it is placed. So we get a good understanding and overview of all of our questions. And like I said, we can also go in and edit any of the questions directly from here, which makes it easy to just go in and add an extra 5 points to all of the questions, for instance, or to change the wording of a certain question without having to go to each panorama and find each quiz card individually in the hotspots. So it's all here in one place. In a similar vein, we also have a centralized list of all count to score actions contained within this tour. Since these actions are added by means of a hotspot, we have the name of the hotspot here and below the media in which it's contained. And also the option to go in and edit, for instance, the amount of points or the score to which this should count. And on the bottom here, we have a useful sum of all of our e-learning questions. So we have the number of quiz questions, the number of count to score actions, and the total sum of the points that can be achieved. So the sum of all points from the quiz cards and from the count to score actions combined. Now, this is especially useful if you want to achieve a certain maximum number of points. So imagine you'll want to have a total maximum of 200 points. Then we can directly go in here and add 5 points to this question and 5 points to this one, achieving a total maximum score of 200 points. Here to the right, we have a qualification table where we'd also need to know what's the maximum score achievable in order to set these values here. So to get 200 as the maximum for excellent, and from here downwards to very good, acceptable, etc. So for that too, we need to know the exact total sum of all points. Now, in terms of layout, we have a real-time preview here of all of the e-learning windows. So the score, the quiz card, and the timeout window. So we can see in real time how our windows adapt when we change settings and options here on the right-hand side, activating or deactivating options inside the windows. So in the report, for instance, when we deactivate these, we would immediately see what this would look like in the window without having to hit preview and load the entire tour. And this is especially useful for the styles down here. So we can edit the style, colors, and font of pretty much all elements contained in our e-learning windows. In this first part, we have elements that all three window types have in common. Down here we have the elements that are unique to the quiz cards. And last but not least, the part that's unique to the timeout window, which is this little clock icon. First, we have the background color, which is this color of the windows right here. By default, that's white, but we can select any other color or even insert the code for a specific color we need. The veil would be everything behind our windows, so what's covering or darkening the media behind them. By default, this is black, but we can change the color or simply leave it black but change the opacity to make it more or less dark. Now with this being darker, a window would stand out more, for instance. And we have a shadow option, which would simply cast a shadow of the window, providing an impression of depth. And again, we could change that color or opacity. We can change the font of both the titles and the other smaller text elements. So again, we can adapt the color and then select a different font. Any font that you have installed on your computer. Let's take this one. We can make the text bold or italic, and we can change the text size. And the exact same thing for the other text elements. If we switch over to the quiz cards now, you'll be able to see that these settings also apply to these other window types because we are currently editing the parameters of this upper part, which is common to all windows. We can change the button color. See how it applies to all buttons in all window types. And now there's a separate setting to edit the OK button. And one to edit the color of the X inside the close button, which we'll just leave white so that there's enough of a contrast to the button color. Below, we have the settings that are specific to the quiz cards. This first bit is to change the size of the actual window as well as the media inside the window. So, screen size. This is the width of the window compared to the overall width of the screen. If we change this to 80, see how the window becomes wider and covers 80% of the screen. So that's how we would make the window bigger, for instance. And in media size, we can set the size of the media in comparison to the size of the question card window. For instance, if we set this to 100, you see that this now covers 100% of the question card width, and there's no room for the actual answer options. At 90%, we would have a tiny space left for the answer options, so just play around with this and set it according to how big you want the image to be and how long your answer options tend to be. If they're shorter, you obviously have more room for the image. This preview is a general quiz card preview that will apply to all of your individual quiz cards inside the tour. So make sure that there's not one answer option in one of the quiz cards that does get cut off. And the same applies for the height of the media inside your quiz card. So we could leave less space here for the media, but let's set it back to 100. Under arrows, we can change the color of the arrows that appear whenever you have a photo album in here. And under circles, we can define the colors of the answer option, whether for the neutral ones, so the ones that have not been selected, as well as for the correct and the incorrect ones. For instance, for the neutral one, let's use this color instead. And here you can see how that translated in the preview. For the correct answer, let's use a more bluish green instead. And for the incorrect ones, this one. All right, so now we have those options matching the overall color scheme of the whole window. Similarly, we can also change the color of the actual letters inside the circles. So rather than white, let's make it black. Although we will leave it white so there's more contrast. So all these options, like I said, are for the quiz card. Lastly, we have the timeout window. As you can see, the text color and the background are already changed from what we did here in the general part. But now, unique to the timeout window, we can change the color of the watch icon, which by default is black, but we could make it white or change its opacity level. So that is how we can completely adapt and customize our e-learning interface to make it match, for instance, the style guide that we chose already for the skin in the virtual tour. Let's have a look in the preview. And as you can see, that's our quiz window with our customized colors, the font, the size of the general window, and the media inside it. This part with the answer options, and thanks to this, have it matched the interface of the rest of the tour, or your customer's general website guide, or their corporate colors, etc. Same goes for the score window, which is exactly how we saw it in the preview inside the program. And our timeout window. So everything is perfectly customized and uniform to leave a professional impression of the overall virtual tour experience. With this button down here, we can reset all these settings so that when we click it, it'll jump back to the default colors and settings and the original design of these e-learning elements. Be mindful with this button though. I mean, you can hit Control Z to undo this, but just be careful not to lose all your carefully set colors up here. So I'm gonna hit Control Z to go back to my settings. Now, finally, let's have a look at these three new options up here, which, similarly to how you could already proceed with skin elements, will allow us to save and even share these settings for future projects or with coworkers to maintain the same line and layout. You can save these settings to your personal library, export it as a file and share it with a coworker, or take it with you to another computer. And with this button, you can open your library to open and use design profiles which you have previously created. So let's save this design, for instance. So we click this button and we'll see a pop-up window which asks us to classify the design just like it does when we save skin elements to our library. So it asks us to assign it to a certain family or folder, which will allow us to keep all our designs ordered and structured. So first we can create a family to assign it to. Let's name it test for the sake of this example. Or we could select a category that already exists that we have previously created. Type would be a subcategory within our respective family, for instance, to separate lighter designs from those that use darker colors. So let's create a new subtype combining all dark designs. And here we'd simply define a name for this specific design. Let's name it Design 1 and hit Save. So now we have our layout with all these options saved to our library. Let's open our library and here it is. And from here we could open and reuse it on any of our future virtual tour projects and it would simply apply to the e-learning elements without the need to go through all the colors and settings all over again. If we click it, we can see a preview open here to the right where we can have a look at each of the elements and what they would look like. Here on the left-hand side, we have the categories which we just mentioned. And below that, their respective types, classic and modern. So that's how you can keep everything organized and select and preview your designs. And if we select it, it gets applied to our current project and we can then also go in and fine-tune the settings and colors, etc. Let's go back to our library and select our design from before. And have a look at how we can save this as an independent file, a .vtl file, which we can send to a colleague of ours or save on our external hard drive and use on any other computer that also has VT Pro installed. Name your file here. If we wouldn't have previously saved this design to our internal VT Pro library, we would now get the window from before where we categorized this design into family and type. But since we already did that, we'll just give it a name, select the path where to save it to, and that's it. Save. And that's how we'd get our file here, which we can share and open in VT Pro on another device from File, Import Library. So with these new options and the ones you already know, you can now customize your e-learning virtual tour down to the last detail. Lastly, we want to explain a new e-learning action which is very useful in particular for quizzes. And that would be this one, Elearning Timer. This timer allows us to control the countdown, the timer in our e-learning tour, in such a way that we can make it pause and resume. Let me show you an example. You know how you can have a timer in your e-learning tour to limit the time your participants have to complete this training or quiz. Now, there might be occasions in which we'd consider it convenient to pause this timer. For instance, when opening a quiz card that has a rather long video inside which the user needs to watch, and you want them to take their time to watch it without the added rush to have the time run down on them, and you'd even want them to be able to watch it several times or pause it before replying to the question. That's what we can achieve with this new action. So the idea is to go to the panorama, to the respective hotspot that opens this quiz card, and also add the action e-learning, e-learning timer, pause. This way, when the user clicks on the hotspot, it'll open the quiz card and pause the general timer. Now, while the user opens this quiz card and watches the video and hasn't replied yet, the timer is paused. If we'd leave it like this, the timer would not resume. It would just stay paused. So in order to have the timer resume once the user selected his or her answer, we'd have to go into this quiz card and select this option down here, which allows us to launch an action as soon as the user selected any of these answer options, no matter whether they selected the correct or incorrect one. And the action to be launched would be e-learning, e-learning timer, resume. So now, when the user opens the quiz card, the timer pauses, and when they select any of the answer options, it resumes. Let's check it. Look for the hotspot. As you can see, the time is running, and if we click on the hotspot, our quiz card opens, and indeed, the timer pauses. Now we could take our time to watch the video and think about the answer. And as soon as we select our answer or click on the closing button, the timer resumes. And this is an action that you can add to a hotspot or to a skin element to have better control over the whole e-learning experience. And that would be it for this fourth part of the e-learning tutorials. Thanks for watching.